Hey, how's everybody doing? It's Michael here, and we gotta talk about that Jared Cannonier versus Calvin Gastelum fight, specifically in regards to Calvin Gastelum, because man, the sun is getting real low for Calvin Gastelum. Now, okay, let me preface by saying this. Calvin Gastelum's last six fights, they've all been competitive, save for the Jack Hermanson one, and even that one, you can make the argument that it wasn't like he got starched. It's just he got caught early. Things happen. But the point I'm trying to make is, while Calvin Gastelum has been competitive in his last six fights, it's still losing five of your last six. All that to say that Calvin Gastelum is definitely on a bit of a downswing here. And that has led me to the question of, what do we do with Calvin Gastelum? Now, for me, I think Calvin Gastelum's in this weird limbo territory where he's clearly good enough to beat unranked opponents to anyone from about 10 to 15. You know, he beat a very tough Ian Heinisch. I think he could beat Kevin Holland walking away at this current stage of Kevin Holland's development. I think Calvin Gastelum could beat Edmund Shahbazyan. I think if given another shot at Jack Hermanson, that fight could have gone differently. But at this stage of his career, I don't think Calvin Gastelum could beat the upper echelon of the division. And the problem that Calvin Gastelum's running into is that he is still a name that people attach to that Israel Adesanya performance, and therefore he keeps facing top line competition, which he cannot reliably beat. And so, as a result, he keeps racking up these losses. And, I mean, it's like this. In an isolated term, I don't think that's a big deal for Calvin Gastelum. And the reason why I don't think it's a big deal for Calvin Gastelum is because of the way MMA fandom works. See, MMA fandom is a weird thing because while MMA fans are a lot of things like fickle, short-sighted, ruthless. One of the few redeeming qualities about MMA fandom is that they tend to be forgiving of losses. I mean, really forgiving. Mark Hunt is a good example of that, and there's a lot of other fighters who have less than stellar records, and at one point or another were in talks of maybe winning a title. So, don't get it twisted. I don't think Calvin Gastelum is in trouble in terms of his current standing in the UFC or legacy. But it's a question of fairness. Is it fair for Calvin Gastelum to lose five of his last six and still have a spot on the UFC roster when Alistair Overeem can lose one fight to Alexander Volkov after going on a bit of a win streak himself and get himself cut? No, I don't think so. So, that again leads me to, what do you do with Calvin Gastelum? My indication is, I think you keep him on the roster. I think you make him the initial gatekeeper into the top 10. Have him face guys like Shahbazyan, Holland, Heinisch again, I guess. But you get what I'm trying to say. Shamayev, if Shamayev is going to be there. Have him fight Uriah Hall or Luke Rockhold. These kind of guys who are just outside the top 10, but aren't necessarily in the contendership status. I think giving Calvin Gastelum fights like this would probably be a better indication of his abilities and where he's at this stage of his career. And if Calvin Gastelum goes on a 4-5 fight win streak, bring him back into contendership. But it's clear that right now he's not in that contendership status. And thrusting him into these matchups against top flight competition is just A, gonna make his record look worse and worse when it's all said and done, but B, is just not a good way to use and maximize his abilities at this point. But that's just me. That's just my thoughts. Let me know what you think. Comment down below. And yeah, I know we didn't have a podcast this week around, but guys are busy. Guys are moving around. Lockdown is done, etc., etc. So we'll have a show eventually, I promise. But until next time, I'm Michael. This has been the Light Kick. And remember, y'all, stay safe.